Hey friends, Ashton here with 10 Cents with another fragrance review. Today we're taking a look at a fragrance from the house of Calvin Klein, Euphoria Liquid Gold for Men. I'm cheap ass, so I bought this used off of Notino, formerly known as Beauty Spin. So I'll show you how the box comes if you buy something used from there. Sometimes they have decent deals, sometimes the deals suck. It's kind of hit or miss. If you go up into the upper left hand corner, I think it's sales maybe, there's a little selection for open box perfumes. They usually have a couple hundred up there at a time for men. And like I said, sometimes you can find decent deals there. So the box will be exactly as I got it from Notino. It's not the prettiest thing on earth, but that's just because of the shit that they stick on it. So we'll go ahead and check out that presentation and then we'll check out the fragrance itself. All right guys, let's go ahead and check out the presentation for Euphoria Liquid Gold. Again, this is how the box came from Notino, being purchased as an open box. So if you buy anything from them through that category, this is how it's gonna come. You can see here, it says Euphoria Men Liquid Gold. You can see some sick tape that's been put on here. There is a little bit of a textured pattern that you can see right there, which is pretty nice. It continues all throughout the box, the color just changes. On the back, you have the ingredients and Calvin Klein's address information here, typical stuff. They do throw on a fantastic sticker on the top to let you know what special number you are. And then on the bottom, they throw another sticker on there, which they use to cover up the batch code because nobody needs to know that anyhow. So the thing that really sucks about that is, so far in my experience, these stickers are on there pretty well. If you try to take them off, they kind of just rip into a thousand different pieces, and a lot of times they'll take off some of the box with it. So if you're a purist and you want the boxes for presentation with nothing on it, you probably don't want to go with the open box perfumes that they have there. But like I said, sometimes you can get good deals, so it just depends on whether that's important to you or not. For me, I don't really care that much, but I know some people do. So here is the bottle, again, Calvin Klein Liquid Gold Euphoria Men. You can see through this if you hold it up to a light, but typically it's pretty hard to see through. And then you have this little metal bar that goes around the sides and over the top. It's got a nice gold coloration to it. You can lift it by the cap if you want to. It doesn't click into place, but it slides into place really nicely. The atomizer on this is pretty decent. It gets the job done. And then on the bottom you've got sticker with typical information. It is a nice presentation for a Calvin Klein bottle. It looks classier than most of their offerings, so we'll give this one a thumbs up. So the name Calvin Klein by this point doesn't really conjure up any thoughts of anything that's cutting edge or even decent in terms of quality if we're talking about fragrances. Most of their new releases are pretty crappy unless we're talking about the yearly CK1 Summer. And that seems to be accepted with lukewarm appreciation, where people say, yeah, it doesn't smell like shit, so I guess it's okay. And it only lasts for 3 hours, but it smells kind of fruity. That's kind of where Calvin Klein has gone to at this point. So I didn't have very many expectations, or I should say high expectations, for this fragrance. And it only has three notes if you look at the note breakdown. Obviously there's more than that in here, but they're just giving you three notes to work with. This one's a little interesting in that when I first spray it on, every time I've worn it, I always feel like, oh, this is gonna last a long time, it's gonna project really hardcore, because that's what it kind of gives off the vibe of. But it really doesn't. It does project pretty well. I would say average to maybe slightly above average, you know, an hour and a half to 2 hours of good projection. And it lasts for 6 to 7 hours for me. But my skin sucks for retaining scents. Some people I've read get just crazy performance, and then some people say they get piss poor performance. So I guess the jury is still out on this one. For me, it's average to slightly above average, but I'll take that because a lot of Calvin Klein fragrances just don't really last long at all for me. Pepper is the top note to this, the only top note that they give. But it really is almost devoid of pepper in the way that you would usually associate smelling pepper, because usually pepper has kind of a bite, you know, it's got that kind of spicy tinge, and it doesn't really have that. The fragrance doesn't have that. There's almost a vanillic sweetness in the open, But it's not actually vanilla. It just gives off that vibe. Really, this is more saffron and sandalwood. It's a creamy sandalwood. And I guess the pepper is adding in some of that spice, or what you would call a spice in the fragrance, that kind of edge. But really, it's a sweet fragrance. That's what it mainly is. From the open to the dry down, this is a sweet fragrance. And that's coming from the saffron and the sandalwood. As it dries down, it loses some of that edge that you get from the spice in the first couple hours. And also that vanillic kind of sweetness dies down as well. So what you're left with is the creamy sandalwood mingling with saffron. It's actually done pretty well, especially for a Calvin Klein fragrance. It doesn't smell super cheap or anything like that. Maybe the opening is a little more synthetic feeling than the dry down, but it's a pretty good fragrance overall. I'm not gonna reshoot that. All right, so that whole note breakdown and everything can be summarized really quickly. This is a sweet fragrance the whole way through. It's got kind of a vanillic feel with a little bit of spice in the open. That goes away, it gets toned down, and you're left with the creamy sandalwood and saffron. And it's, like I said, semi-sweet at that point, but it's predominantly a sweet fragrance. So what does that mean? What is it good for? That means it's gonna be good for nighttime, it's gonna be good for colder months. It could be a date night fragrance depending on how much you spray on. And if you wanted to, you can spray on a little more and wear it to a club. Seems like everybody wants to wear super sweet stuff to a club, so this would work there. So this is not really a daily wear kind of fragrance. It's not something that you would bust out and wear to the office or spray on every day as a signature scent, at least in my opinion. It's more one that you would pull out in certain occasions. All right, guys, that's what I've got for you for Euphoria Liquid Gold by Calvin Klein. Again, for me, it's a like, not a love. It's toward the top of Calvin Klein's recent releases, but honestly, is that really saying that much at this point? Probably not. If you like really sweet fragrances that are masculine, maybe you'll dig this one and you should check it out. I wouldn't pay more than $35 for it. But yeah, that's just my recommendation. I'm sure there are lots of people out there that love this head over heels. It just doesn't blow me away. It's not anything, you know, super out of the ordinary or anything that really grabs you. It just smells nice. But there are lots of fragrances that just smell nice, and there's nothing wrong with that. So until next time, thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. I'll see you guys next time.